Another Ethan Journal video. So this is a question that a lot of YouTubers have actually been asked lately, and that is, why do you use your certain platform? Like, why do you use Windows? Why do you use Linux? Why do you use macOS? Well, I'm here to tell why I use macOS. And I haven't always been a macOS user. I think my first ever computer, I built a PC, and it was a very low-end PC, and I've never really been a big fan of Windows, so I installed Linux Ubuntu Budgie, and I probably lived on using Linux Ubuntu Budgie for probably about maybe 3 years, and it worked quite nice, except the software library wasn't as large. And then over time, I found I really liked Apple products. They've always been speedy, they've always been very useful, and the fact that Apple's ecosystem, I had an iPhone, and then if I got a Mac, it would just be that last piece to the puzzle to make the entire thing go together. And ever since my switch to going completely Mac exclusive on almost everything I do, it's really made the experience a whole lot better. The fact that if I sit down at my desk, I can plug my phone in, and then on my Mac, everything, I don't even need to turn on my phone. I can answer phone calls, answer texts, answer emails, everything right from my Mac without having to do any configuration on my phone. The fact that everything works together is just amazing. And you're going to notice up here, I am using macOS Big Sur. I have just recently upgraded to Apple's M1 architecture, as I think the first Mac I ever used had Apple's PowerPC architecture, and then I had my So I had a Power Mac G5, then I went to a 2010 iMac, and then I used my family's MacBook Pro from 2014, which is still my family's current MacBook. And then just a few days ago, I finally upgraded my own computer to a 2020 Apple M1 Mac Mini, and it's really been quite a smooth ride throughout the entire time. There's only been a few times I've experienced issues, and I've never tried to be myself an early adopter. I have waited for everyone else to experience the issues, and once most of them are fixed, I'll join in on the new and improved stuff that Apple has to offer. Now, Macs, in my opinion, are great for almost everything. They may be a bit more expensive, but there's almost nothing you can do on Mac. There's almost nothing you can not do on a Mac. Unlike Windows, which has a lot more support, Mac is a lot more, I guess you could say, locked down. So I've never ran a virus scan on my Mac, whereas I think it was like 3 months I actually had to use a Windows PC. And I had to run a virus scan every morning, and within just a few weeks I had already gotten some sort of adware. And I've never experienced that on a Mac. I've never had that problem. Maybe it's just because Apple security is really locked down, like they really care about your privacy, and it's just been a great experience all in all. Now, the fact that Apple has their own suite of software is amazing. When I got my Mac and I had like documentation, just a small amount, if I wanted to open a file on here, I can just open up Preview or Pages and it'll just be there. It's already pre-installed. Whereas on Windows, to open up almost anything like that, you have to download Microsoft Office just to open a simple PDF, which makes the experience a whole lot worse for me if I'm on Windows. Now, yes, Apple products don't have as many support for gaming. Now, for me personally, I'm not a big gamer. I don't game that much, but if I did, I still would switch to Mac. The few games I do play, like Minecraft and Roblox and Asphalt 9 Legends, those games work completely on Mac. And if they don't, I can run it in Apple's Rosetta architecture or use Wine to convert Windows programs to Mac. And I've never really had to do that. The small amount of programs that I actually do use all work perfectly fine on a Mac. Now, looking at just my app catalog, I have games on here and stuff that I play on my iPhone, as Apple has just switched to the M1 architecture, as well as Apple's whole suite of apps. I mean, Windows Movie Maker isn't great, but have you ever tried opening up iMovie and you have almost all the effects to make a simple but pretty cool movie? I made all my first YouTube videos on my other YouTube channel all in iMovie, and it looked pretty professional. Now, Apple has gone a long way in their new Apple M1 architecture to make it so if you have an app that you really like to play, or a game you like to play, or just a regular app you use and it's on your iPhone, if the developer allows it, you can actually run that app Well, on your computer. And that is just amazing. As you can see here, I have games like Among Us, Hill Climb, Bit City. Like, all these games are games that I've loved to play. And apps, even, like B&H Photo, their app works on here, as well as I've got eBay. I don't need to go to the website. It has its own app version. They've got MeWe. They've got an Apple's whole suite of their own apps, which is crazy, as well as my video editing software of choice, DaVinci Resolve, is almost entirely Mac exclusive. And the fact that Apple has such a diverse catalog from making tablets to phones to computers, it may be more expensive, but in my opinion, it's worth the extra buck. And Mac computers have always been on top, on the almost always on the latest hardware, giving you the best experience. And that's why I choose Mac. That's my opinion on why I use macOS over Windows and Linux. Even if someone tried to pay me like $2 million, I probably wouldn't switch to Windows. I just don't like Windows, and that's me. You can criticize me all you want, but I'm always going to be a Mac fan. I've always been an Apple fan. And I think I'm going to continue to use macOS as long as I can, as it is as good as computers get. And in my opinion, it is as good as computers get, as well as Apple is really pushing the boundaries of what computers can do in their software and hardware. So thank you all for watching the video. Have a great rest of your day, and goodbye.